Uzodinma breaks silence as human heads litters the street of Olo in Imo. Collins Opuruzo exclaims. The insecurity in Imo State has reached a shocking height. At the break of each dawn throughout this week, residents of Olo have continued to wake up to decapitated human heads displayed in public places. Today it was at Orie Okoro in Olo that yet another head, fleshy, cut off body and dripping with blood, was dropped on a table and left to the full glare of the public. If the protection of lives and property is still the primary purpose of political governance, Chief Hope Uzodinma should never have any business in the governance of the smallest tier of the modern state. While the harvest of heads is ongoing in Olo, Uzodinma is in Fairway, Abuja, doing nothing of any significance to Imo people. Not a word has been heard from his regime about the appalling situation. No single effort has been made by the man to understand the situation, guide the people, allay their fears, and protect their lives. The truth is not so much that the regime of Uzodinma has failed, than that Imo currently share all the semblances of an ungovernable space, and each day brings a sorrow which the next day makes worse. A general air of fear, terror, horror, despondency, and despair hovers around the populace and across Imo State. Whoever that builds on government for life and safety is only building on quicksand. It is also like gambling with one's life. It is abominable for Uzodinma to sit idly and receive monthly allocation while headhunters take over Imo State. He also pockets the security votes and secures nobody but himself. He taxes the people to starvation without service delivery, and he, in the end, looks the other way as his people are beheaded like goats. He does not visit any part of the said state, even in the face of the most atrocious happenings. But he is quick to junket around in Abuja for his maximum pleasure. If something as outrageous as human heads littering the street could not bestir Uzodinma to speak to the people, visit the people and act to reassure and protect them, he now needs to explain to Imo people what his mission among them is. And the only valid conclusion is that it gives Uzodinma orgasmic satisfaction to watch agonies reign in Imo State. You see, at first, Uzodinma is not the duly elected governor of Imo, if I'm not mistaken. And you and I know, Uzodinma is a mistake in governance. Yes, I want to put it that way. He's a mistake. He came in through the back door. So he's a mistake to the people. He is a mistake to Imos. So that is why you see him committing all sorts of mistakes. He doesn't have the quality of a leader. Uzodinma doesn't have the quality of a leader. Uzodinma is not the type to govern the people of Imo. And that is why, even while he contested as a governor of Imo, he never even took second, he never even took third, neither did he took fourth. You see that? Even the courts themselves testified it that they never gave him the approval to represent APC. So how did he got the approval to be the flag bearer of APC? Not to talk of contesting as a governor. That is it. You see the problem? So he came through the back door. So we cannot recognize such person. We cannot support such person, because such person is a complete disappointment. Uzodinma is a disappointment. Uzodinma is a disgrace. Yes, to the people. This is happening in Imo because of Uzodinma I don't care attitude. It's not my business. It is not my business. If it comes to running to Abuja to report issues concerning his people, you will see Uzodinma on the run to Aso Rock to meet the president, Mohamed Buhari. That is why he, President Mohamed Buhari, gave him the embarrassment of his life by chasing him away the last time he went to Abuja to make another complaint. And Buhari chased him and said, "Go, please, and take care of your people." The crisis in Imo today is the cause of Uzodinma. It's the cause of Uzodinma. These Easterners are not comfortable because of Uzodinma. Uzodinma is the problem in the Southeast. So what do you expect?